Welcome to FC Montreal Soccer on the USL Pro YouTube channel. I'm Joey Alfieri. With me, Sofiane Benzaza. Sofiane, Montreal still winless, but they've shown some steady improvement as the season's gone on, even getting a difficult 1-0, but they lose 1-0 to Richmond last week, but they did show some good signs of improving.
Much better FC Montreal performance. Offensively, they really tried a bit more desperate in the second half, as we saw. The input of a few MLS veterans in the team to really help out. And this, you know, the history repeats itself against the Russia Rhinos, a team they lost against a few weeks ago, 3-0 harshly, and with more MLS newcomers coming in to help the USL team.
And as you alluded to, they are going to get some help again today, just like last week against Richmond, an infusion of first-team talent, guys like Anthony Jackson, Amel, up top, Louis Belangoyed, who's going to be here all season. Jeremy Gagnon-Lepari, Vandré Lefebvre on the back line. What do those guys obviously bring in terms of quality to a USL Pro lineup?
If you look at guys like Eric Miller, Vandré Lefebvre, they bring MLS experience. They have, you know, a dozen MLS games each to bring that infusion of experience, talent, and also a bit more physicality against a much more stronger Russian Rhino team in the, you know, in the. And we're going to see also Marcin Kripo get his first professional game minutes to be able to, you know, see where he's at.
And when the Montreal Impact created this joined USL, the keeper position, they had the guy who's going to be between the pipes today in mind. That's Max Kripo, who's been rehabbing a shoulder injury, and he's finally ready to go. What do we know about him?
Well, you know, he's a big guy, physical, very strong on crosses, and we'll see how he's at physically. He's been training with the first team for a while now, and is finally ready to play his first professional minutes and to be able to see where he's at. You know, Youssef Daha having a look at him, Jack Sturm with the USL team is gonna see where his progress is, and Rilo see how far he is into his preparation to be the first team goalkeeper for FC Montreal.
Kripo will be the fourth different goaltender to get a start in USL Pro this season for Montreal. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of result he can get and if he can propel Montreal forward today. It's Montreal against Rochester for the second time this season. When we come back, we'll have kickoff. welcome back to Saputo Stadium Turf Field as FC Montreal is getting ready to take on the Rochester Rhinos. Second meeting between these two teams, Rochester winning the first one 3-0. You'll remember Montreal had a defender who was sent off in that game. It was 1-0 when Frank Zoué was sent off.
One man down for a big portion of that game. That's and two goals by Valeski, who's now starting for the Rhinos.
That's right. Valeski, Christian Valeski had come off the bench in that game. But as we mentioned in the pregame, a lot of first-team talent on Montreal's roster today. A lot of young players. But definitely some talent on the field for both sides. Rochester has some established MLS veterans, USL Pro veterans, Mike Garzy, Johnny, Tony Walls. So it'll be interesting to see if Montreal can pick up their first win in USL Pro. And we are underway here. Montreal will possess the ball first. Louis Bélanger-Goyette finds Temguia, who finds a first-teamer, a guy with a lot of experience, Vandré Lefebvre. He brings a lot of quality to the back line, right, Sofiane?
Great distribution, very more aggressive than people think, and his excellent distribution with the ball for those long passes in which he has a signature in MLS and probably will give in USL for today.
Hasn't played a competitive match in quite some time, though, Vandré, so I guess that's why he's coming up here. Another first-teamer, Eric Miller, dispossessed in the middle of the park. Here comes Rochester. They enter into the area, and here's already a decent run here by Timmy Mulgrew. But he loses the ball, and it goes out
for a
goal kick.
Good job by Secunda to protect the ball and let it go out of goal kick. Secunda was very impressive last game against
the kicker.
Fast young man, good left back, technical, and we really help a lot. Lajoie Gravel on the left side, who surprised me as a winger. I saw him more as a center forward, so great stuff by both last week.
And another thing we mentioned in the pregame, Max Crepeau making his first start of the season. This is a guy who Montreal envisioned having as their starting keeper, was rehabbing a shoulder injury, and is finally ready to play. And here comes Johnny Mendoza with some speed. Finds Valeski, who crossed it into the box, but nobody home. Crepeau will scoop that up. Start things off right away. Lajoie Gravel sends it off Pat McMahon. It goes out for a Montreal throw.
FC Montreal in a sort of 4-2-4 formation. Very offensive players. Lajoie Gravel, Romario Williams, and Jackson Hammond and Morelli up front.
When you have just one goal in the season at this stage, I think you need to
go
try to tweak things, yeah. Eric Miller finds Temguia. Rochester will possess the ball as we do a little giveaway takeaway there. Gagnon Lapari called on a foul on Valeski. You know, I think last week, and Sofiane, we get a chance to see early in the season, we get a chance to see some of the quality teams in USL Pro. We've seen Rochester once. It's the second time they're here at Saputo Stadium. We saw Richmond last week. And Montreal didn't pick up any results against those sides, but they looked okay. They didn't look out of place.
They didn't look as bad as we thought for
Absolutely
our first
not.
Team, for first trial at the USL level.
Number 17 in blue. You will recognize him. He was the third overall pick in the 2015 MLS Super Draft. That is Romario Williams. Made his MLS debut earlier this season against Orlando, coming off the bench.
Has impressed in preseason camp for the Montreal Impact. So did Morelli, who was with the Impact in Mexico for the preseason camp. So a lot of these players, Olaf Roy knows a lot. Including a few MLS inserts. So it's going to be really interesting to see how Romero Williams plays in this game.
Sean Touch will send a deep ball. Rochester will hold possession, but Mendoza will give it away to Vandré Lefebvre, who will send it back to Crepeau. Jackson Amel tries to bring that down with his athleticism, but nothing doing there.
It's going to be interesting to see the combination between Romario Williams and Justin Amell, how they combine, what's the chemistry like, and go from there.
Walls looking for Mendoza in the area. A little long. Mendoza tries to settle it down. It'll go off Eric Miller for a corner.
First test for Maxime Crépeau on a set piece. His first professional set piece of the year, and see how he handles that. He's going to be aggressive. He's going to depend on his taller center backs. It's going to be exciting for him and a kind of nerve-wracking probably.
Mendoza will appear to swing this into the box. And a nice early save by Crépeau there. Ball kind of went through the 6-yard box a little too easily there.
But the
crisis
header,
averted.
The header wasn't as strong as you would hope for Rhinos fan, but Crépeau able to touch the ball in that situation and makes him feel more and more comfortable. Good news for FC Montreal.
Morelli goes to Temgia. We'll find Eric Miller. Send it back to Crépeau. Crépeau already got a few touches early in this game. Lajoie Gravel will settle it down for Vendry Lefebvre. A nice touch by Romario Williams. He's going to take on Pat McMahon. What can he do with this? Williams coming down the left side. Dispossessed by McMahon. Lajoie Gravel finds Gagnon Lepare. Lefebvre will try to swing that one in there. Broken up by Apostolopoulos. See what a young player like Temgia can do against a veteran side like Rochester.
I really liked him last week. He's a young man, tall, physical, but not quite technical. But, you know, it's more his reaction time. He needs to let go of the pass faster sometimes. A few times early in this game, he's been pressed quickly by the Rhino players.
And there he is. He looks for Morelli. Couldn't connect on a deep ball there. I think we'd agree that Morelli was very dangerous last week as well. Played a good match.
And he had a good support from Yannouk Charbonneau. Good chemistry with him, and Miller should hopefully show up offer the same thing for Morelli as support-wise.
Miller and Valeski kind of get there at the same time. Interesting collision. Valeski's already been knocked down a couple times in this game.
They're back playing at home. FC Montreal playing at home, looking to establish their rhythm. Aggressive with this quite a few MLS inserts during this game.
Mario Williams has the ball on his foot. He'll get it back to Secunda. Finds Belan Goyet. Montreal holding a lot of possession early on, which is good to see. I think if you speak to them, I think the young players want to do a better job of coming out of the gate strong.
Exactly, especially you know Ryan's team that's playing this time, playing away, looking for the quick break for now. And FC Montreal has the tools to really hurt them early in this game. They have nothing to envy the Rhinos.
Mendoza goes down. Sorry, Sofyan. Mendoza goes down after a challenge in the air with Jackson Amell. Jackson Amell just a little bit bigger than Johnny Mendoza. Secunda finds Lajoie Gravel. We'll send it back to Vendry Lefebvre. We've played 8 minutes in this match. Still no score between Rochester and Montreal. Williams with the two-handed shove to the back of Julian Ringhoff.
Early in this game to establish a pattern, but for now, a lot of long balls towards the FC Montreal strikers looking to run behind the Rhinos defense.
They haven't been able to connect just yet.
It could work without Van der Castel, who's on the bench for Rhinos. So
yep. Obasi as well played a huge role in the win against Montreal and setting up the opening goal.
It should take advantage of that during this game.
Another long ball. Nobody able to be on the receiving end of that for Montreal. Here's Walls. And he's looking for Mulgrew. He's going to make a nice run down the right side here. Timmy Mulgrew. Send it into the box. Little long for Mendoza. That's going to go out for a goal kick.
But overall, that play, FC Montreal had the play under control, it seems. Everyone was marked correctly. Wendell Lefebvre making Mulgrew take the cross as fast as he could. But still a dangerous chance by the Rhinos.
Miller. Temgia. Little high for Morelli, intercepted by Rochester. Sean Tosh with the throw in. Canardo Forbes gets a touch. Miller whiffs, but he's able to recover. And oh, he almost takes out the camera or DI.
High pressing by the Rhinos. Very aggressive.
Touch, settle that one down with his chest. Rochester will reset as Pat McMahon retreats to get the ball. He plays it to Brandon Miller. Miller dealing with a bit of a finger issue last week. Ended up playing the first half against New York Red Bulls. Game that Rochester won. A very impressive start to the year for Rochester. First five games of the year on the road. Come back undefeated, 3-0-2. They pick up the win in their home opener, so this is definitely a strong USL side. Montreal be tested today. Crepeau clears, but it finds the foot of Tony Walls. Walls will send it in. Mendoza's going to be offside here.
So and gradually, the Rhinos are asphyxiating the FC Montreal defense. They are unable to transition the ball to the midfield quickly, so very high play by the Rhinos. Early 10 minutes into the game, that little shift of momentum. But let's hope Vandre Lefebvre can lead his team out quickly to go offensively.
Lefebvre is he's definitely brings some quality to this game. He's played some good MLS matches whenever he's gotten in there.
Very reliable player.
Very reliable.
And the whole team can take advantage of his experience. He knows most of them, probably as a big brother kind of.
Yeah, not
kind of
but not an old
it.
Guy exactly. By any means, mid-20s. But he definitely brings a lot of experience, a lot of quality to the table. Likes to call himself the best fantasy hockey general manager on the team. Vandre Lefebvre does.
You can't do worse than me.
No, nobody can do worse than you. Crepeau getting a lot of touches in this game.
Well,
especially
you know,
early on.
That's the problem right now. When you have this 4-2-4, sort of a lot of pressure is on Louis Bélanguet and Garon Lapareille to really transition the game quickly to get the ball to the forwards. So, and the Rhinos know this. So try to, you know, create a cannon between both sides of the pitch.
The long throw. He was looking for Romario Williams. But again, headed away by Rochester. Seems like a lot of the action's gone on this right side for Montreal. Miller finds Williams with a throw-in. Jeremy Gagnon-Lapierre, who really hadn't played in a while, he really, really got stronger as the game wore on against Richmond last week.
He's the captain on the pitch for today.
Absolutely. And he finds Mele Temguia. Will find Vandre Lefebvre in the middle of the field. And Sukunda plays that ball, but bad touch goes out for a Rochester throw.
Unnecessary, lost ball there, unforced error. The FC Montreal can afford to do a lot of these against the experienced Rhinos team.
Sukunda picked up a couple knocks last week, talking to him after the game. Had a nice little welt on his abdomen. He's laughing about it, though. Played a very strong game, as you mentioned before, Sofiane. Played very well, young player. Ball goes out for another throw. Touch. Look to swing that one into the box a little bit too long, and Crepeau will scoop it up. Have you visited the new USLsoccer.com? Get the latest news and live stats and check out the new social media hub. That's USLsoccer.com. Rochester retreats. Here's Sukunda coming down the left side.
Could be dangerous.
And a foul there in a dangerous area. Good call, Sofiane.
Quick play by, was it Sukunda or Lajoie Gravel?
You might be right. It might have been Lajoie Gravel.
Who passes to Jackson Amel. And, you know, the aggressive Rhinos defense saw the danger. I said, you know what? Maybe a foul is better than having the dangerous pass in the box. And maybe a first home goal for both FC Montreal and yourself, Joey.
Yeah, I'm ready for it. Whenever they decide to score a goal at home, I'll be ready, and hopefully that'll be sooner rather than later. So. But you feel it coming, though. I think you, with the way they've improved from what we saw against Toronto FC 2 in the first match, here's Romario Williams with a strike. Well wide.
Low and wide.
Would have liked to see him do a little better there. But from what I was getting at before, Sofiane, I think from where they started against Toronto FC 2, first game of the year, to where we are now, I think Montreal, I mean, is leaps and bounds. I know they haven't gotten a win yet. They haven't scored much yet. But I promise you, for those of you who haven't seen the first four matches, that there's been a lot of growth, a lot of improvement with a lot of these young players.
And the staff expect them to suffer for the first few months, but the frustration will come from the fact how much quality they have shown and then get any tangible result out of it. So that's more frustrating, but they're going to get there. It's it's a long-term process. This is the mandate of these academy USL teams.
Tim Gill intercept a little high for Lefebvre. Tony Walls finds Touch. We'll find Mike Garzy. Canardo Forbes, who haven't called his name too much today, to Pat McMahon. McMahon sends a long ball in. It'll be a little too far for Mulgrew. But it's officials say it was deflected. It'll go out off Montreal. It'll be a corner for Rochester. Second of the game.
Yeah, Tim Mulgrew, New England Revolution draft, MLS draft player.
That's right, one of the players on loan. Sends it into the box. A little high for Valeski. Just missed him. And unlucky for Montreal, it actually goes out for a throw and not a goal kick.
Clearance there.
Looking for Williams, a little too high for him. Settled down by Julian Ringhoff.
Unforced errors.
Here comes Mulgrew again.
Hasty
turned
decisions.
Over. Belongo yet hasn't had the ball on his foot. Makes a run right now. Gets around a couple Rochester players. He'll send a long ball in. Jackson Amel just a little bit behind him, though. Sukunda settles it down to Lajoie Gravel. You touch on it, Sofiane, a bit of a different role than what we've seen from Lajoie Gravel so far this season.
Much more, he's a holding midfielder, but with offensive instinct, he doesn't mind going up. So when you have two defensive midfielders, center midfielders being next to each other, they can't both go to the attack. So you have to do a little switch, one defends, one goes to the attack. So Babylon-Guyet really doesn't mind.
And here comes Canardo Forbes. He's taken down by Gagnon Lepari. He'll be called every time. Is he going to get booked? He will. He's going to pick up a yellow card. I think it was a yellow card well earned.
Now the foul was kind of dangerous, so the yellow card was warranted on that one. Dangerous scoring chance for Forbes.
Mendoza will swing one into the box, headed away by Lefebvre. Will he be able to get there before it goes out? A nice run, a good hustle from Lajoie Gravel to keep the ball from going out. And he's making a run up the left side. Jackson Amel, pass a little soft. Jackson has to slow it down. Played back to his defender. Gagnon Lepari finds Tim Gia. Well, sky one. Montreal couldn't get on the end of that. Mike Garzy heads it forward for himself. Oh, good collision there.
But D'Angelo Mendoza showing his back. No, not Mendoza.
Secunda.
I mean, Garzi showing his...
yes.
Garzi showing his back
Secunda
to
Secunda. Down, that's right.
Exactly.
Belongo yet. Looking for Lajoie Gravel down the left side, but he's missed him. It's picked up by Brandon Miller, keeper for Rochester. We'll slow things down a little bit. Not much, not many dangerous scoring chances for Montreal here early on.
But the rhythm of the game is a bit more, you know, hide and seek between both teams. And obviously, the Rhinos are a bit more dangerous, more direct game, able to find spaces on the sides, but on the wings. FC Montreal needs to be able to fill the gap between the defense and the four offensive players. That's key. You can't leave them alone, stand on an island without giving them decent balls and those long balls.
Secunda will just clear it. Nobody there for Montreal. Rochester resets. Just goes to what you're saying, Sofiane.
Exactly. Those loose long balls against, you know, experienced athletic defenders. You got to use their speed. And who have seen Mantro Morelli for now?
That's right. Become a fan of the USL on Facebook for exclusive league news and interactive content. You can search the USL Pro on Facebook. Come up with a bunch of exclusive information there, stuff you can't get anywhere else.
Surprised Tony Walsh wasn't called for a high cleats there, but play continues.
Garzi and Miller with a little exchange there. Temgia on a nice move, but he couldn't get away from Cornardo Forbes. Forbes to Sean Tosh.
It would have been nice if he succeeded.
Eric Miller gets beat by Tosh down the left side again, but he recovers nicely. Can Morelli fight him off? He absolutely does. It's going to be a foul call on Tosh. Free kick to Montreal. 22 minutes into this one. Still no score, Rochester and Montreal. Vandele Lefebvre making a nice run, but intercepted by Pat McMahon. Garzi plays it up the right to Mulgrew. And Jackson Amel with a little clutch there, and he'll get called for that. Apostolopoulos. And the Rochester bench asking first player to kick the ball out of bounds. And they will do that now. A little bit of some confusion going on the pitch here. Not too sure what's going on.
But we're still going to applaud the fair play no matter what.
Yeah, I guess so. When in doubt, fair play.
Exactly.
Secunda to Gagnon Le Pare. Switches sides, finds Miller on the right.
Good run, 1-2.
Very nice run. Morelli, Belangoyet. Oh, and a nice play by Mendoza. Ross Miller had a lot of room to run there. Would have been dangerous for Montreal.
But these are the kind of things, you know, Lafoy expect from his players. You see this 1-2 combinations. Morelli getting involved in a triangle with Miller and Belangoyet. So this is the path for them for success in this game.
Secunda will give the ball away.
Faster ball transmission. He can't afford to hold the ball too long.
Lajoie Gravel makes a nice run. Nobody there.
Kind of disappointing the foul wasn't called there.
No call there. The official tells Romario Williams to get up.
A bit frustrated today, Romario Williams.
Mostly not too long much balls. Early on, no. Another difficult touch by Secunda. Ball goes out for a Rochester throw. Apostolopoulos able to jog back onto the field. Pat McMahon. McMahon with the throw coming for Rochester. Finds Tony Walls. Nice ball forward, but it's headed away by Vandré Lefebvre. Williams and Jackson Amel still looking to build that chemistry together, obviously, up top.
Even though they seem to have similar profiles as strikers, I think they have enough quality and they just need to communicate better to really be able to feed off each other.
Yeah, and that'll come with some little bit of time, a little bit more playing time together. Here's Gagnon Lepare. And Williams dispossessed again. He's on the turf, but nothing doing there. Secundo will be called there.
If you go back to that play, it didn't seem that Romero Williams was waiting for the ball.
No.
He didn't seem he expected the ball to be coming at him that way. I think he was expecting a ball over the defender and he makes a run on a long ball.
Good point.
It's a question of getting that chemistry. Again, we don't want that gap between the midfield and those four offensive players.
Rochester will swing it into the box. It'll be picked up by Crippo.
But if we talk about a gap on this side, the FC Montreal defense and the midfield is going to insulate a bit better in the last 10 minutes, the Rhinos forwards. We haven't seen much of them. Outside maybe Mendoza being very very elusive sometimes.
Joao Gravel taken down there. Goes down hard. Free kick earned for Montreal. Mele Temgia will settle the ball down. Miller Mendoza has been an interesting one today. It's been a good matchup so far. Pelan Goyet taken down. You hear head coach Bob Lilly giving Canardo Forbes some constructive criticism. Gagnon Lepare finds Temgia. He has Miller with some space on his right. He finds him. Miller to Morelli. Kicked out by Rochester again. Belan Goyet looks for Lefebvre and he finds him in the middle of the park. Lefebvre will take a strike. It's going to be well wide.
Very confident there, but we know he has an excellent long range shot. But
that's a little too long range, though.
Most probably. But, you know, he wanted to make something happen. He didn't see any much activity around the box, be able to do a pass maybe. And, you know, as soon as he got the ball, we knew he was going
to
shoot.
Any truth to the rumors that you've scored from there in your career, Sofian?
On FIFA 14, I remember.
14, not even 15, okay.
No. Lack of budget.
Heard that one before. Gagnon Lepare in the middle of the park. Belan Goyet taken down again.
The Rhinos really, you know, kind of killing the rhythm as soon as they cheeky fouls, and FC Montreal needs to find a way.
Yeah, they don't foul in dangerous areas.
Exactly. They're just killing the rhythm, and FC Montreal needs to release the ball faster and be exactly
Miller
like
Morelli,
that.
Very nice, Sofian, you called it. Miller stops, try to swing it into the box. It's blocked by Apostolopoulos. Miller gets another touch on it, finds Gagnon Lepare. Belan Goyet finds Secunda.
Nice switch by FC Montreal.
Yeah. Jackson couldn't get there. Easy scoop up for Miller. But a nice little give and go there between Morelli and Miller.
Like you said before, the right side has been, the FC Montreal has been heavy on the right side. And Miller has been very active.
Lefebvre wins that battle in the air against Forbes. Ball ends up on Morelli's foot. Oh, and a hard foul.
Dangerous
there.
Foul.
That's going to be a yellow card.
A yellow with a tint of orange,
Walls,
if you ask me.
Dangerous foul there.
Yellow with a tint of orange.
Good to see Morelli get back up right away. Belan Goyet looks like he's going to take this one.
Not many people in the box, so play it quickly.
Could Morelli get here? He stops it. He'll cross it into the box. Headed away by McMahon. But Montreal's earned the corner.
Nice stop play by FC Montreal. It's all about positioning, not necessarily size on set pieces. And, you know, Morelli with a good pass at the second post, but McMahon spotted very quickly.
There's a corner for Montreal. Belan Goyet will take this. Montreal often opts for the short corners, but doesn't look like that's going to happen right now on this one. Giving away. Canardo Forbes steals. And a nice play by Secunda to break that up.
Another tackle. Great job by Secunda.
Good stuff.
He really saved their very dangerous breakaway counterattack by the Rhinos.
Benoit Goyette to Gagnon Lepare. Find Eric Miller on the right. Temguia had to hurry up there as Valeski put some pressure on him. Benoit Goyette looks for Miller. Gagnon Lepare looked to swing one into the box for Morelli, but it's headed away by Toch. Jackson called on the foul there. Follow at USL on Twitter to become a league insider. Join club conversations and have a chance at exclusive giveaways. That's at USL on Twitter. Touch. Nice play by Morelli. Unfortunately, couldn't settle that one down. It goes out for another Rochester throw. Walls. Just to fend off Gagnon Lepare. He did that nicely. Temguia in front of Forbes. Louis will head it forward. Lefebvre tried to clear. Unable to do so. Again, Sofiane, you've been talking about a lot of turnovers for Montreal, unnecessary ones.
Which plays into the game of the Rhinos. They can recover quickly and they can quickly bring numbers down in the box against Montreal, so they need to be more careful with that.
Here's Williams, finds Lajoie Gravel to Secunda. Secunda will play it back to Crépeau, so Montreal has to send it back to their keeper quite a bit. Sofiane so far in the first half, 32 minutes in. No score between Rochester and Montreal. You know, people are going to look at the last scoreline, last time these two teams played, and there's Lefebvre who sends it well out of play for Rochester throw. And they're going to see the 3-0 result for Rochester, and they're going to say, oh, well, Rochester, much better side than Montreal. You look at the records, you look where they are in the standings, you say this should be domination by Rochester. But that game, the first game was extremely tight, 1-0, until a defender for Montreal got sent off.
And it was their first USL opposition non-academy
That's
team.
Right.
Non-MLS U23 team. So
absolutely.
It was a great test, and they were doing well until that red card. But to be honest, like we said, it's progression, and it's a very good sign for Olafroy and his staff. And a one win could really bring a tangible result, something tangible to all the hard work they've been doing early in this season.
Absolutely. Here's Lefebvre looking for an option, but it's actually headed away. And here comes Canardo Forbes. Canardo Forbes will join into the area. Strike, and it goes over the goal. This organization.
And forced errors.
Absolutely.
Risk-taking that doesn't need to be done. You know, it's Crépeau won't be unhappy 100%. He's getting action, and he won't be as nervous as he was before the game, if he ever was. But, obviously Montreal had a good 10 minutes of domination, and now they can't let the Rhinos back in this half. They need to really push.
Rochester coaching staff telling Canardo Forbes, you got to relax in that situation. He skied one there. A great scoring opportunity, but wasted. McMahon looking for Mulgrew. It's Mulgrew against Secunda. Secunda just kicks it out of bounds. Smart play there from the young left back. And here's Canardo Forbes again, spilling over down the right side. He's able to keep it from going out. Forbes will cross it into the middle, but it will go out for a corner kick. Sent away by Montreal. Here's a cross. Headed away by Secunda.
So still alive.
Still alive, it is. Crossed back into the box. It's headed towards goal, but Crépeau there again. That was Julian Ringhoff.
Great elevation on that play.
Yeah, got some. He's got some good hops, but Crepo was up to the challenge. Here's Fabio Morelli. Looks for Jackson, who finds Eric Miller on the right side. Sent out by Garzi. Miller throws into Jackson Amell. Here's Mendoza. Canardo Forbes. Ball that's just a little too long for Mendoza.
Good tracking back by Eric Miller on that play.
Yeah, Miller's been pretty good today.
If you survive Azteca, you can survive Stats of Turf Field. That's what I say.
That's a good point. You obviously came off the bench in the Montreal Impact's first leg of the Champions League final against Club America. Nike is a proud partner of the USL. Follow at Nike Soccer on Twitter for all the latest Nike Soccer information. Tim Gill played back to Max Crepo. Tim Gill finds Lajoie Gravel, who finds Belan Goyette. Dispossessed, though, by Mulgrew. Plays it back to his keeper, Brandon Miller. Base head forward, Lefebvre against Valeski, one-on-one. And there's going to be a foul called there on Valeski, but that could have been dangerous.
Could have been dangerous, but Lefebvre was probably looking to pass it back to Crepo, and Valeski tried to sneak in there with an unseen foul, but good call by the refereeing crew.
Here's Tim Gia. Pressured by Mendoza. He has to retreat. Send it back to his keeper, Max Crepo. Crepo calling for Tim Gia to come back to him. He gives him the ball. Finds Gagnon Lepare. Not much room out there for Montreal, Sofiane.
High pressing by the Rhinos. Not enough options for the defenders to reach the ball. And right there, the last ball by Morelli couldn't get the ball. But, you know, didn't... FC Montreal needs maybe to play a bit deeper in their zone to get out faster, but at this point, Rhinos are really asphyxiating FC Montreal.
Asphyxiating, I like that.
Is that a word?
Yeah, pretty sure it is. And here's Vandré Lefebvre. Nice little fake there. Buy himself some more time. Lefebvre looking for Romario Williams, but it's headed away by Ringhoff. Mulgrew sends that one out. Lefebvre again, trying to get something going here. Sends it to Crepo, back to Tim Gia. Lajoie Gravel will be able to, and it's a nice header from Lajoie Gravel to get it forward to Romario Williams.
Nice run.
Lajoie Gravel calling for the ball. Oh, a little bit of a difficult touch there. Goes out for a corner.
Nice pass by Tim Gia to start the play. To find an open space It was good, you know, really quick passing, you know, no nonsense, and you don't lose the ball, a lot of unforced error, and corner kick right there.
Belan Goyette will take this one. Getting into the box, Tim Gia right there, but Miller comes out, scoops it up, cuts right in front of Miller, or excuse me, right in front of Tim Gia. Miller does. Not an overly high corner, but well placed.
Very very quick.
That's right.
Sliced corner kick and gave enough time to Miller to react, who seemed to look like he expected the ball to come into his box quickly.
McMahon looks to Valeski, who settles it down with his chest. Here's Canardo Forbes. Finds Johnny Mendoza. Here's Forbes, but a nice play by Morelli. Rochester able to recover. Tony Walls. We'll chip one into the box. Here comes Mulgrew. But it's tipped by Lefebvre. Montreal keeps it from going out. And Miller will clear.
Good clearance.
And it's headed away from danger by Apostolopoulos.
Precise, good clearance by Miller there. Justin Hamel could have had a chance to control it and play with it if it wasn't for the intervention by the Rhinos defense. And it's very important. that they have the capacity to clear smartly and just clear into the void.
Morelli has a cut on his knee, and that's why he's going to have to come off. There's a little blood there. Training staff will have to get that cleared up. Throw in from Montreal. Sent up high. Jackson didn't like the way Tony Walls ran into him. Tried to return the favor, but he's called. 40 minutes in, still no score between Rochester and Montreal. Not many quality opportunities between the two sides here. Walls taken down again. And a quick play in by Rochester. And here they come. Here's Mulgrew looking to the right to Mendoza. Mendoza gets centers it. Nobody there. Belongo yet will be able to clear. And he does, but he...
Nice there.
Yeah, the ball finds a Rochester player. And here's Mike Garzy. Garzy will try to swing it into the box. Miller able to head it away and head it out of play. Goes out for a Rochester throw. Here's Walls to Canardo Forbes. Little high for Mulgrew there. Montreal able to clear, but still not out of danger just yet. McMahon settles it down to Apostolopoulos. Rochester holding much more of the possession now. Gagnon Lepere gets a foot on it, but still Rochester possesses, and McMahon lets the ball go just under his foot. He has to retreat to go back and get it. Lefebvre clears. Romario Williams will try to get there. He's unable to. It was close.
A little push by Romario right there. A
couple times. He's
not appreciated by the by Miller nor the Ivanos defense.
It's two or three subtle little pushes there from Romario Williams so far in this first half. Feisty player.
He's been a bit frustrated this first half. So was Jackson Hamel. Not much quality balls for them.
Jackson Hamel will force Miller to put that ball into play. Temgia to Gagnon Lepere. Eric Miller on the right side. Another good clearance from Miller. Touch. Finds the center back Ringoff. We'll try to swing it into Valeski. Valeski against Temgia one-on-one. Finds Canardo Forbes. Forbes has some good speed, but he's dispossessed. And it's cleared by Montreal. Here's Jackson Hamel. We'll play it forward. Is Gravel going to get there? And a nice play, nice sliding play by Pat McMahon to end that. Here's Garzy to Canardo Forbes. Forbes finds Sean Touch. Gets it back to Forbes. Ringoff to McMahon, and I think, you know, Rochester just happy to hold some possession here as first half winding down. They're building up the attack, but still not many great scoring chances, right, Sofiane?
No, not many, but as soon as FC Montreal loses the ball, they're able to really, you know, go out front quickly like right now. They're able to really project themselves offensively.
Mulgrew with a strike, just over goal. Rochester putting the pressure on now.
Just like that. You know, very quickly, you know. They're able to recover the ball quickly, go up front and really, you know, do some damage, you know. Remember the Forbes chance.
That's right.
Who shot it high and wide.
Yeah.
But once again, unforced errors by FC Montreal, and they need to be much more sharp.
Vandré Lefebvre will get a foot on it. All USL regular season and playoff games are available live, free, and in HD on YouTube. Connect with the USL YouTube channel today. Sofiane is a little sensitive, so I don't want to make that joke that I've been making all season about seeing him in HD.
I'm not sensitive.
So I will not make that joke.
I'm not sensitive at all.
You good?
I'm very good. Thank you, Joey.
Excellent. This will be a Rochester free kick that they'll just put into play. Here comes Walls. Finds Mendoza. Valeski taken down. No call there. Interesting clearance. Morelli able to settle it down. Good run by Morelli to get there, but he's going to turn the ball over. Here's Toch. You'll cross it in. It's blocked by Temgia.
I don't fully understand the dribble by Morelli. They didn't need to be that risky. But
it was difficult for him to get to that ball, though. I mean, I don't think he was expecting that type of clearance. Risky, but good on him to settle it down.
But the dribble after was kind of unnecessary. Could have given the ball to Miller or Lefebvre or Temgia to clear it, but
Lefebvre breaks up that play again. Good first half from the first team defender. Eric Miller there. It's intercepted by Toch. Finds Canardo Forbes. Now Montreal in possession. Here's Morelli. Finds Jackson Amel. He's got Lajoie Gravel on his left. He's not going to go to him. Here's Anthony Jackson Amel making a nice run with a strike, and it's just wide.
Almost.
Nice play by Jackson.
Showing his speed, showing his eagerness to go up front, and really scared the hell of the Rhinos defenders. They really had to back away quite a lot, and he had the chance to really give time and space to himself and shoot.
He had Gravel going down the left side. I thought he might have taken that option, but a good decision to kick. He just misses the goal by inches.
But kudos to both Omar Williams and Lajoie Gravel making the runs to keep the Rhinos defender on their toes.
And that will do it. Halftime here at Saputo Stadium Turf Field. Not a terrible showing from either side. Not very dangerous. Not many great scoring chances, though, Sofiane.
A good even game. A little edge to the Rhinos, obviously, with the most dangerous scoring chances. And right there, Jackson Amel almost gave the lead for FC Montreal before the end of the first half.
So 0-0 going into the halftime break. It'll be decided in the last 45 minutes. We'll see if Montreal can collect their first goal at home, their first win in USL Pro. All that when we come back for the second half. Right now, it's Montreal 0, Rochester 0. Welcome back to Saputo Stadium Turf Field. After 45 minutes, 0-0 between FC Montreal and Rochester. But a pretty relaxed first. Well, I shouldn't say relaxed because there's a couple guys that picked up some good-sized knocks there. So it was relaxed for me up here in the booth, but it was a pretty easy-going first half.
Not as aggressive and as other games as the last time they met 3 weeks ago, but a few scoring chances on both sides. The Rhinos a bit more dangerous with Canado Forbes with the best chance there and a few corner kicks that Kirpo was able to handle easily on a few lobbed headers.
You'll see the Forbes chance right here.
Exactly.
Very high, very wide.
Radley, and you know, FC Montreal making some changes.
Yeah, they're going to make a pair of changes. A couple first-teamers should be coming out here. If I look at who's available on the field, it looks like Eric Miller, the right back, and Vandril Lefebvre, the center back, are both going to be coming out. Mitch Bringolf, the last game after he picked up a in Harrisburg City, will come in. Jeannouk Charbonneau will come in for Miller. So those are two young players, but two young players who have done well this season for Montreal.
We'll see how the shift maybe of power will go in the second half with those few changes.
Still,
Romario Williams and Jackson Hamel up top for FC Montreal.
Rochester was coming on strong there towards the end of that half, but Montreal probably, Anthony Jackson Hamel probably had the best chance of either side.
Almost scored
Montreal's first home goal. Here's Mike Garzy. We are underway in the second half. Substitutions have been made official. Lefebvre and Miller are off after 45 minutes. Bringolf and Charbonneau are on. And here now is Canardo Forbes. Forbes trying to test Secunda. And that's going to be a Montreal throw. The official originally thought that was going to go to Rochester, but nope, it is a Montreal throw. Good play by Secunda. Jackson Hamel gets ahead on it, but nobody there for Montreal. Here's Canardo Forbes. He's got a little bit of room in front of him. Looks for Volesky. It's a little long. Mendoza has a nice burst of speed. That ball is out.
The Rhinos not wasting any time to go up front. Maybe taking advantage of the new subs. Going at Bringolf and Charbonneau quickly. But mostly Bringolf right now, who's been teamed with Temgwe at center back.
That's right. This is going to be the first Rochester corner of the half. Swung into the box. Apostolopoulos settles it down. Here's Forbes. He'll find Mendoza on his right. Mendoza will get it to Mulgrew. Mulgrew's got a little bit of room. He'll cross it into the box. Rochester gets ahead on it, but it's out. Walls will attempt to keep it in, but it's going to go out for a goal kick.
Rhinos continue to be dangerous on corner kicks, using their size and positioning, but Kirpo didn't have to do any saves on that one, so good news for FC Montreal.
Charbonneau on the right with a long ball to Romario Williams. He'll settle it down. Nice first touch from Charbonneau there as he enters the game early in the second half.
Williams not shy with provoking the center backs and then the left back of the Rhinos, dribbling his way into the box and corner kick. So good anticipation by Romario Williams on that play. And showing his skills a little bit to try to make something happen.
Here's a corner for Montreal. Belan Goyet will stand over it. It's a short corner to Morelli. A little bit of a difficult first touch from Morelli there. And Rochester will clear. Charbonneau's on it. Finds Belan Goyet. It's into the box. Miller leaps up. And he comes up with it. Mulgrew. And a little bit of a soft call there on Romario Williams.
He did impede a bit Mulgrew on his run, but you know, it's 50-50. But you know, I understand the
maybe play on there, yeah. Nice anticipation from Morelli there to intercept. Here's Morelli. Gets across. Gets by a couple Rochester players, finds Lajoie Gravel. Lajoie Gravel against McMahon. He crosses it in. Nobody there. A little too long. It's going to go out for a goal kick. Opportunity wasted for Montreal.
Well, McMahon made Lajoie-Gravel go on the outside. Gravel still with a very smart dribble to try to cross, but unfortunately his cross was not precise enough for a dangerous chance for FC Montreal.
Here's Walls going for the long ball to Volesky. Volesky, he was able to get there. Oh, and just wide.
I thought that was going in.
It looked like it was going in from here, but he just missed.
The Rhinos quickly taking advantage of the young center back duo. Long ball behind their backs, and really, you know, beautiful pass by, I think it was Forbes or Garzy. I missed that one. And nice run by Valencia.
Very nice run. He had to slow down and wait for the ball, but
still had
a shot it, yeah.
I still had enough time to arm his shot.
Here's Forbes. He'll send it into Volesky again, but broken up by Bringoff. We'll play it to Crepeau, who will clear. This team's trading some good scoring chances early on in the second half. But Montreal hanging in there with a veteran team. McMahon finds Forbes. Here's Canardo Forbes with some good speed. And here's Volesky in, but just offside. It's a nice ball from Forbes. Here it is. That was Walls who sent it into Volesky here, as you see on the replay.
Had enough time to armor shot. Nice lob.
Nice little chip there. Nice little lob. Just missed.
He made the center back duo look bad on that one. That's part of the learning process for these young kids.
Romario Williams finds Belan Goyette, who will look to his right, finds Charbonneau. Ball ends up on Romario Williams' foot. Back to Temguia. Here's Belan Goyette. Nice give and go with Belan Goyette and Gagnon Lapare. Here comes Montreal. Here's Secunda. He'll cross it in. Lajoie-Gravel has an opportunity. Tries to cut back, but Mike Garzy intercepts. And you'll get it away from danger here as Johnny Mendoza will come up the left side.
The runners make sure that as soon as you get close to their box, you don't have enough time to armor shot.
That's
so
right.
So it's always important to try to put yourself in a position to have a one-time shot, but it's not easy. All
good,
the time.
Good observation, Sofiane. Here's Walls. Gets around a couple impact players. Finds Mendoza. Rochester slowing things down here a little bit.
Very similar to the last game between both teams. FC Montreal unable to resolve the Tony Walls equation. It has been very excellent this game.
Walls has been very good all season. Lajoie-Gravel is going to try to get a burst of speed. Couldn't get there, but Montreal will get a throw. If you visited the new USLsoccer.com, get the latest news and live stats, and check out the new social media hub. That's USLsoccer.com. Ball will be played back to the keeper, Maxime Crepeau.
Jackson Amel playing on the left wing a little bit, trying to find makes himself invisible, forgotten by the Rhinos defense.
He's been dangerous. He's played in two matches for Montreal. He's provided them with some quality scoring opportunities. Hasn't found the back of the net just yet, but you can sense that it's coming. Bringolf. Try the long ball, but it's intercepted by Apostolopoulos. Finds Mendoza. It's played on the left by Rochester. Here's Walls again. We'll change sides, gets things going on the right. You know, Rochester content, just slowing things. Go for the long ball as Apostolopoulos finds Mulgrew, who heads it to Forbes. McMahon gets it back to Mulgrew. We'll try to get close to the box here. Valesky upended but stays on his feet. It's chipped ahead. And there it is. And it's just offside. No, foul. The players aren't really sure what's going on.
But still a dangerous chance for the Rhinos.
Very good chance.
Nice chip pass into the box. Kripo with 50-50 between Kripo and I think it was Bringoff to try to hold off the Rhinos forward trying
it
to
was.
Score.
But Kripo very alert. Looks very good. Bad touch from Gagnon Lepere. Try to win the ball back, but he doesn't. Walls to Mendoza in the middle. And here's a nice run. Rochester's going to come down the left side. Cross it in. Kripo picks it up, and there's some contact with him there. But he's up quickly. Some contact with Valesky. But Kripo looks okay. Hunched over now. As we mentioned before, he was rehabbing a shoulder injury in the offseason. That's why you haven't seen him in USL Pro action just yet. Romario Williams charged with another foul.
Showing his frustration a little bit there, but he's not being vicious about it. Just trying to get the ball.
Rochester player is in some discomfort. That's Mulgrew.
Looks like he hit his calf. Mulgrew's calf right there is limping right now.
Mulgrew with a terrible limp. Rochester will get the ball back into play. Here's Tony Walls. Tony Walls just so efficient, so effective in the middle of the park, eh, Sofiane?
He's really feeding off Mendoza. Also, they both have excellent chemistry, experience, and, you know, for deep-lying center midfielders, they have quite the talent right there to really distribute the ball and really, you know, dribbling qualities and crossing qualities that has been huge, especially for Valesky, who's been feeding off their excellent passes and, you know, wreaking havoc into the FC Montreal's center midfield area.
Looks like there's going to be a couple switches, a couple of substitutes are warming up here. Montreal might do more. Here's Johnny Mendoza coming into the box. Mendoza finds Forbes. Ball goes to Mike Garzy, who finds Pat McMahon on his right.
FC Montreal looks a bit under siege.
They do.
Early in the second half.
It'll be time to make some more changes. Forbes will play it to Sean Toch. Canardo Forbes. Back to Toch. Toch will get it into the box. Valesky's there and it's in. Christian Valesky with the header and it's 1-0 Rochester.
A lot of space given to the Rochester left back, Torsh. And basically, he was able to put an easy cross into the box. Nice anticipation by Valesky. And Kripo was beaten, you know, on the timing. It happens all the time. No one marking Valesky. Running.
Again.
Into the, running.
That's
the story of the last game.
He had the two goals in the second half. The last time these two teams played.
But
and Valesky doing it.
But credit to Valesky with the run into the box.
Absolutely.
He was unmarked. Was able to time his run with the Torch's cross into there. Given too much time to get the cross, and you know, it's almost mathematical. You can see it right
see
there.
See the replay here.
Chabonneau give him space, maybe too much respect, and look
little
at the cross.
A little too much room, yeah. And there's Valesky, just nice header, nice leap, and he puts it by Kripo. And now Rochester will make a change. Timmy Mulgrew is going to limp off, and Alex Dixon will actually come into this game. Dixon started the last time these two teams played, coming off the bench here today. Unfortunate for Mulgrew. Had a good game, but they picked up a knock. And now Montreal will have to regroup and hope they can find a first goal on home soil.
Still keeping the same kind of formation.
Would you make a switch? Would you try to tweak it at this point?
At this point, you need to find a way to communicate better between both strikers and the midfield. Whatever it's Omar Williams, whether it be from the bench, a guy like Ndiaye who has speed. But you need to find a way to get everyone on the same page.
Forbes tried to play it into the box. Couldn't get it there. Mendoza has the ball on his foot. Garzy back to Forbes.
A bit of tiki-taka here by the
Montreal's
Rhinos.
Montreal's got to be careful. You can't concede again.
They're too comfortable in the FC Montreal side of the pitch.
And a foul called there.
I would definitely be interesting if Philippe Lafroy brings in more speed on the wing.
Yeah, you know, every time that DI's gone in there, he's really overwhelmed a lot of the fullbacks that he's played against. So it'll be interesting to see if he's one of the guys warming up here.
Maybe he could wreak havoc on Matt McMahon.
Become a fan of the USL on Facebook for exclusive league news and interactive content. That's facebook.com, and you can search for the USL. Some great content there. Here's Mendoza. Gets it back to Walls. As Rochester looks like they're going to bring on another substitute. Here's Mendoza. Finds Toch.
Velasquez has been roaming around between the defensive line and the midfield line of FC Montreal, really making himself invisible, forgotten, and gets the ball as a pivot striker and has enough speed, you know, to really go one-on-one on any of these guys.
Here's Dixon.
And is never really marked.
Here's Dixon with the ball. Finds Walls. Walls will get it to Canardo Forbes. Forbes will take on Secunda, and Forbes with the left foot, and it goes wide. Good build-up.
He was able to get
Rochester.
It too easy on that box. He kind of faked his way into the box. Everyone was expecting a cross, but he went in, cut into the box, and with a shot wide, once again for Forbes, but it has been dangerous, as he was last time both teams played.
Crippo, very vocal, urging his players on forward. He'll send it to his right. Unfortunately, Morelli unable to keep it in. It was a difficult task, a lot to ask for Morelli. Temguia's got some time as he retreats. He finds Gagnon Lapari. Gagnon Lapari getting to Jackson Amel, but Pat McMahon intercepts. And here's Canardo Forbes. Forbes finds Valeski. Taken away by Temguia, who gives it right back to Canardo Forbes. Forbes looking, finds Walls. Gets it back to Forbes. Pat McMahon to Mike Garzy. Rochester holding possession for quite some time now. Apostolopoulos, as head coach Philippe Lafroy, wants his players getting forward. He wants his players to put more pressure on Rochester.
Aggressive without fouling. They need to recover the ball and try to break the rhythm of the Rhinos. They've been really settling in. You know?
As Mendoza's taken down.
It's just the Rhinos sitting down. They put a nice couch, having some tea, and really, you know, having a party right there. And the party on the...
A tea party.
Exactly. And, you know, it's Lafroy's very frustrated with that. Looking at his players right there. Charbonneau, good job.
Yeah, good anticipation from Charbonneau. Here's Morelli now. Finds Jackson Amel. Bit of a high ball as Charbonneau will try to take on Apostolopoulos, but Apostolopoulos there first.
Once again, too hasty of FC Montreal. They had enough time to sell the ball in. Ball on the ground, much more precise, much more efficient, and they lose the ball again. The Rhinos, who only, you know, wish to have these kind of balls and be able to recover quickly. So
there's Mike Garzy. He's taken down. Two Rochester players taken down. It's going to be a yellow card to Louis Bélanguet. Rochester will make another substitution. Guy who had himself a fine afternoon, Tony Walls, will be coming out for Tyler Rudy. Walls will give the captain's armband to Pat McMahon. So Tyler Rudy will make his way into this match. Tony Wall's effective once again, having himself another good game in the midfield. And Rochester gets by and it's in again. Right after the substitution's made, Rochester will make it 2-0. And things falling apart fairly quickly now for FC Montreal in the second half.
Very harsh, but this time we cannot say it was not deserved by the Rhinos. 11v11, and it's a breakdown.
64th minute, and it's 2-0 now, Rochester. They're pulling away. Valesky just gets around Crippo.
Nice play by Valesky. You know, he's, like you said, he has speed, and as a pivot striker can really establish himself in the box and showed both skills right there.
Yeah, as you hear, PA announcer announced Valesky again. Sounds like a recording. This is four times in two games for Valesky against Montreal.
Unfortunately, for FC Montreal, he's hurting them, and quite deservedly.
He's been very good, and here's Bringoff. Turns it over to Alex Dixon. He has a burst of speed. Dixon into the area. Dixon will take a shot on goal, and it's off the side of the net. But another good, dangerous opportunity for Rochester.
I'll give credit to them. Guia was able to handle him on the side, make him take the outside shot.
Lajoie Gravel, aggressive there. It'll go out for a Montreal throw. Milan Goyette, he has time. He's got some space. Go for a long ball for Morelli. Morelli able to settle it down. Can he do anything with this? Morelli's into the area, but it's taken away by Rochester. Montreal put themselves in good spots, decent spots, but they're lacking the finish in the attacking third, Sofia.
Morelli has the skills to go past maybe Torch once, twice, but not 25 times a game. And even if he had to do that, for one main reason, there was not enough support around him. So all these offensive players are being isolated by the Rhinos, and the midfield not able to get closer, and there's not enough communication between all four offensive players up there. So it's unfortunate. There are skills, but it's not just skills. It's about teamwork, be able to be able to work together. As you see, Dixon right there with Valesky and Forbes as soon as he came in.
Follow at USL on Twitter to become a league insider. Join club conversations and have a chance at exclusive giveaways. That's at USL on Twitter. So we're in the 66th minute here, approaching minute 67. Still 2-0 to Rochester. Two second-half goals from Christian Valesky. And Montreal find themselves down. And they've been under a lot of pressure in the second half. Jackson puts a little heat on Miller, but he's able to clear right away. And you have to realize as well, Sofiane, that once you have two guys on the back four, like Miller and Lefebvre, come out after 45 minutes, guys were with the first team, it's inevitable that breakdowns will happen. Overall, though, to be fair, Tim Guia and Bringoff have been very good when they've played this season.
But, kudos to the Rhinos to identify this very quickly and go attack right away.
Absolutely.
Early in the half and the second half, and they were able to take advantage of that.
As Valesky's taken down, earns his team a free kick. And Rudy stands over the ball. Rudy gets it to Forbes, but it's broken up by Lajoie Gravel. Finds Belan Goyette. Give and go with Gagnon Lapari. Belan Goyette not happy there, shoving somebody out of the way.
Surrounded by three round Rhinos players and still able to get away with it. But
a little dangerous from Tony Walls, who was subbed off. I mean, there's a bench for a reason, and he's sitting on the turf. Not the greatest idea there. But here's Gagnon Lapari. Finds the Secunda. Tried to play it in the middle there for Belan Goyette, but nothing doing. Here's Canardo Forbes. Canardo Forbes has played his fair share of indoor soccer as well. He's effective both indoor and outdoor.
Nice pass right there.
Nice ball to Morelli. Can Morelli settle it down? He's taken down in the area.
No penalty? No call.
I cannot believe it.
Wow.
Call me biased. Call me, you know, homer. But to be honest, that's
wow. Should have been a Morelli penalty kick. Taken down in the area. My goodness.
6'3" against 5'5", and the guy falls. I think it's pretty obvious.
Wow. Montreal doesn't get a break. The official says play on.
And it's frustrating for both Temguia, who made the excellent pass, and Morelli, ball. Who made a great run, great control into the box.
Great ball from Temguia.
No call for FC Montreal, even at home.
Headed away by Ringoff. Wow, I still can't believe it. Same thing happened last week. Non-handball call. And you'll see it here again.
Morelli.
Torres touched the ball
before clipping Morelli, but you know what?
Here's a double substitution coming for Montreal. Alessandro Rigi will come into the game for Morelli. And Zach Masuri is in as well for Romario Williams. So Romario Williams' day is done. Rochester also bringing on Colin Rolfe. Rolfe for Mike Garzy. So three substitutions there happen back to back to back. But Rigi and Masuri in for Montreal and Rolfe in for Rochester.
More size up front for the Rhinos.
That's right. As we saw Rolfe the last time these two teams played, he was one of the starting strikers. Here comes Jackson Amel. He'll try to flip it over Apostolopoulos, but Miller gets there first. Great anticipation from the keeper to get there to sniff out the attack.
Going back quickly to that non-penalty call. Yes. As much as Torch touched the ball first, he still didn't try to get the ball. He touched the ball, Morelli could have gone after the loose ball, but he touched him, clipped him, and he fell. He fell over him, so. I have not done a referee course ever in my life, so but still, it was a foul in the box. I think you've seen a couple
soccer games in your day.
A couple.
I trust you there.
Just a reminder, this crew will be in the FIFA World Cup, Women's World Cup 2015.
That's right, an all-female crew today. You've done a pretty fine job for the most part.
They kept it simple.
That's right.
But on that call, it was unfortunate that FC Montreal didn't get the PK.
Absolutely. Charbonneau on the right. Send it back to Bringolf. Charbonneau finds Masuri, who will make one of it, well, his first touch of the game, who finds Jackson Amel. Jackson Amel, good burst of speed. And a free kick there. Jackson taken down. Foot came up very high there. A yellow card.
I was worried that
will be given to Julian Ringoff.
I was kind of worried he was not going to get a yellow card. It was a very dangerous play.
As we'll see here on the monitor.
Nice pass by Masuri.
Very nice pass.
The control a bit heavy. Oh. And a dangerous, dangerous Absolutely. High foot. Very lucky.
Jackson Amel is up, stretching his legs, and he looks like he's going to be able to continue on here.
So FC Montreal sending people into the box. Gagnon Lapare sending his men into the box to try to make something happen.
Need to get one here.
You only need
72nd minute. Here he is into the box, looks for Bringoff, but Miller's so good. He comes up, and he just scoops that ball up before anything dangerous can happen.
Great anticipation. Saw it happening before it happened.
Yeah, he's done that all day. Here's Rolfe making a run against Rigi and Gagnon Lapare, unable to get by both. But he gets the ball back. Big size difference there. Here's Rigi. Comes up with the ball. Good effort from Rigi.
That neck right there. Nice one.
Gave up quite a bit of size, but he's able to come up with the ball. Here's Canardo Forbes. Though Rochester will content themselves with playing it back. Johnny Mendoza looks for Alex Dixon. Looks like Rochester will bring on another defender here. Van de Castiel is up and ready to come on. Here's Zach Masuri.
Nice pass.
Nice ball to Lajoie Gravel. What can he do with this? It's going to go out. It's out for a Montreal throw.
He's really injecting some fuel into FC Montreal engine. I really like this.
Here's Gagnon Lapari with a strike on goal and wide. And Van de Castille will come on for Julian Ringhoff. Van de Castille, another guy who started the last time Rochester was here just a couple weeks ago. Nike is a proud partner of the USL. Follow at Nike Soccer on Twitter for all the latest Nike Soccer information. You can also go to nike.com/soccer. So here, Tony Walls telling Grant Van de Castille that they don't want any goals allowed in this game. They want to go home with the clean sheet. Here's Valeski with a ball ahead to Rolf. Here's Colin Rolf. Will cross. Nice. Dixon unable to finish.
And that's right, but Dixon's been running a good 20 meter anticipating that pass and almost got a foot on that. Dixon really injecting a lot of speed.
Absolutely.
With Forbes going a bit deeper into the midfield, you know, they have options up there on the bench, and Ted Lilly has been using all his assets as much as he can, and with 5 subs per game, you can definitely have different looks on your squad.
Absolutely. Such a deep squad, though, this Rochester team. You can go to the bench when you have guys like Rolf, Van de Castille. Here's Lajoie Gravel now. Cut to the middle of the park. He keeps possession of the ball. He finds Jackson Amel. Try to one-touch it into the box, but it is blocked and sent out of play for a Montreal throw. Beautiful day here in Montreal. Good-sized crowd as well here for this match between old rivals. It's the warmest day since we've had in the booth here, Sofiane.
Very nice.
Couple cool days in April.
Spring left and summer came back.
About time, if you ask me.
Dangerous free kick from FC Montreal. Let's see.
Gagnon Lapari. We'll swing it into the box, but it's headed away by Apostolopoulos. Back into the box. Great, great cross there from Charbonneau, but straight to Brandon Miller. Ball's played to Tyler Rudy, to Van de Castille. Finds Pat McMahon on his right. Back to Rudy. Canardo Forbes to Valeski. Mendoza settled things down, but Gagnon Lapari wins the ball back in the middle of the field. He's hauled down.
Cheeky foul by Mendoza.
And it looks like he's going to get booked.
Yeah, yet again, you know, the Rhinos are able to, you know, make those fouls.
He is.
In the first half, didn't come for a yellow card. Able to break the rhythm. Right there, Gagnon Lapari going, you know, Jackson Amel is going for the run of Missouri, and, you know, Mendoza does his job.
So Mendoza picks up the yellow in the 77th minute.
Frustrating, you know, for FC Montreal. That's part of the game.
Here's Rigi to Belangoyette. Charbonneau arrived late, was taken down there. He looks like he's okay, though. Ball goes out for Montreal throw. Bringolf finds Charbonneau, gives it away, bad touch. And here comes Alex Dixon.
Look out for Valeski.
Dixon coming down the left side. He does have Valeski entering the box, but a great play by Gagnon Lapari to break that up. And he's got some room to roam now.
Gagnon Lapari trying to take over the game for FC Montreal. Getting more touches. And
he'll look to his left, and here's Zach Secunda. Pass a little bit behind Masudi there. But Masudi comes out with the ball. And a nice move by Masudi. With three Rochester defenders closing in on him. The ball goes out. Canardo Forbes. Here's Masudi. Unnecessary turnover again. Ball ends up on Johnny Mendoza's foot.
Trying too much, unfortunately. Very hasty. That goal.
It doesn't have to be pretty, Sofiane. doesn't have to be pretty.
I totally agree, but they have been unsuccessful on set pieces to be a bit more dangerous. And, Morelli should have, arguably could have gotten a penalty call. So
absolutely.
They feel even more frustrated after that. But I agree. It doesn't have to be pretty.
Secunda to Gagnon-Lepere. Finds Jackson with a nice touch there. Unable to settle it down in front of Mendoza. Here's Rolf.
The Rhino is a bit more, finding it more difficult to defend right now.
Yeah.
I see Montreal going at it, but yet again, unforced errors.
Tough ball by Charbonneau there.
There's so much a striker can do.
Here's Valeski. Ball's going to go out off Meletemgia. We're in the 79th minute, getting close to minute number 80. And still, Montreal hasn't found a goal. Bringolf will play it back to Max Crippo, who I think we can both agree, Sofiana, we cannot fault one bit today.
The goalkeepers who play for Estremoz right now at home have done a bad job, to be honest. Crippo.
No, all four guys that they've rolled in. And nice here's pass. Valeski again. Crippo comes out, and it's wide off the side of the goal.
Dangerous yet again,
Valeski almost picks up the hat trick there, but.
Good job by Crippo to make a go on the outside. Yeah. As much as he could, give a chance to his defender to get back and Valeski to miss that shot. Yet again, Valeski.
That's a great point by you, Sofiane, that they've rolled Yann Filion, they've rolled David Pallman, Eric Kronberg last week. I mean, squad is definitely deep in goal. Kronberg, obviously the backup with the first team, but Crippo, Filion, Pallman, those are three young guys. All under 21.
And a lot of assets for Jack Stern to work with and the other academy goalkeeper coaches. And eventually they might get the final touch from Youssef Daha if they make it to the MLS.
Here's Louis Bélanguilette with a burst of speed. But broken up by Rochester as Bill gets it to Canardo Forbes. Ball goes out off Zach Secunda. And it looks like Montreal's going to inject some speed that we were talking about before into their lineup. Victor Di looks like he's going to get some action here in the final 10 minutes plus. Here's Bringolf to Bélanguilette. Finds Rigi. Rigi tries to get around Tosh, but he's unable to do so. Temgia. Was under pressure for Montreal today. Very often they have decisions because Rochester just always pressing. Here's Charbonneau. Finds Bélanguilette in the middle of the park. He'll get it wide to Secunda. Secunda's got a little bit of time before McMahon closes
nice
in.
Cross.
The header just over the goal. Lajoie Gravel couldn't settle it down enough.
Lajoie Gravel, who made the fake run. Lajoie Gravel, who made the fake run to let Secunda get the ball, gets himself into the box and goes for the header. That was a beautiful play. Quality cross by Secunda, something that the FC Montreal has been lacking in this game. And they got a good scoring chance. Brandon Miller stranded in the middle of nowhere, and Lajoie Gravel was able to get the ball, to head the ball.
Montreal makes another switch as Victor and Di will come in. For Louis Bélanguilette.
India quickly going to the left wing, his preferred position.
Yeah, that's five switches for Montreal already.
And we expect Lajoie Gravel to be more the center forward next to Jackson Hamel.
Di with his first touch of the game. Finds Jackson Hamel, who will play 90 minutes today. Played 45 last week. Oh, and a nice move to get around a couple of defenders there. Pass a little bit behind Lajoie Gravel, who kicks it back out to Secunda. Secunda will cross it into the box. There's Charbonneau, settles it down. It's in the area. Strike, and Masudi sends it wide. Another opportunity missed for Montreal as they're coming close.
So close, so close. Yet again, start with Secunda with the cross.
Secunda, a couple nice crosses there.
The Rhino was unable to clear, and Masudi would have strong, beautiful shot, but could have been even more beautiful if it went in. Miller again stranded. Seemed lost out there, and the Rhinos are really suffering right now.
The Montreal coaching staff obviously looking on very frustrated. The team has generated some quality scoring chances in the last couple minutes, but still not on the board at home all season. It's very young season.
There's still hope.
There's still a lot of time, obviously, in this season, but you want it sooner rather than later, and you just have to feel, Sofiane, that when it does come, it's going to be like a pressure, a weight just completely off their shoulders.
And it would confirm a lot of the expectation they have towards the talented young players.
It's hard to explain because, again, they've lost every game this season so far, but they've just shown so much progress, so much skill, so much talent. There's definitely plenty of talent on this roster. It just hasn't translated into success on the field so far.
It is a learning experience, but as players, they want to win. It's all about being in a competitive environment. You know, they're wearing their own colors, or their own logo, Montreal Impact colors. They're all trying to get a pro contract for those who don't have a pro contract yet. And they want to impress for the career and for themselves to really be get better and better. And the USL is a great league for these young kids.
Absolutely. Level of competition is extremely high.
Oh, dangerous foul there.
Gagnon Lapierre.
Oh, no.
He's down.
The cross from Secunda right there.
The cross, yeah.
Back clearance.
The ball ends up on Masudi's foot. Somehow he puts it wide. Unfortunate, but that's as good a look as he's going to get in this league.
It was the penalty kick that the Impact, the FC Montreal did not get.
Exactly.
Basically, and unfortunately couldn't put it in.
So Canardo Forbes is now out of the game for Marcus Ugarte. Canardo Forbes very involved. Ran hot, ran a little cold at some points today. Once
floating
again, the
cross
comes in, and Miller has all the time in the world to go and get that.
Those kind of crosses will not scare any goalkeeper. They're floating, and for Brandon Miller, easy for him on those crosses.
All USL regular season and playoff games are available live, free, and in HD on YouTube. Connect with the USL YouTube channel today. And if you're watching us live now, you've obviously already done so. Joey Alfieri and Sofiane Benzaza here with the call. In the 86th minute, Montreal trails 2-0 to Rochester. Both goals coming from Christian Volesky.
About 5 minutes left, plus extra time to try to get a goal for FC Montreal.
Or two. You need two to get the tie. But we'll start with one. Charbonneau able to get ahead on it. Bringolf will clear. Apostolopoulos settles it down with his chest. Here's Charbonneau again. To Mele Temgia. What have you thought of Temgia today? He's going to be the center back for all 90 minutes.
Well, some good things, some bad things. He could always progress on his delivery, be faster on his passes, not keep the ball as much as he did. But physically, he's getting better since last game we saw him play. Good positioning, a bit more aggressive, but he needs to be faster in his transition game. He's keeping the ball too long, and these professional players, they can really, you know, hurt you if you keep the ball too long and really, you know, go on counter and do some damage.
And a foul there. And here comes Masudi to DI. DI a little bit behind Jackson Amel. He had to stop, but he's able to settle it down. He's going to go for the long ball. He's looking for Alessandro Rigi. Will he be able to catch up to it? He does.
Nice cross there.
What can he do in front of Rudy? Rigi with some nice moves around Ugarte as well. Lajoie Gravel gets it to Rigi. Rigi with the strike. It's in! History! Alessandro Rigi. First goal on home soil for FC Montreal.
Beautiful, beautiful goal by Rigi.
Incredible.
No pressure has been relieved. They scored their first goal.
There's still time to get another one, Sofiane.
There's still, but on that play, Jackson Hamel with a beautiful cross to Rigi. Rigi uses his dribbling skills to go past Torch. Dribbles his way into the box. 1-2 with Lajoie Gravel. We'll see it right there. He dribbles.
This was all Rigi. Good stuff.
Cuts into the middle. Finds Lajoie Gravel as a pivot striker. 1-2. Easy into the box. They can't foul him or it's a PK. And he shoots. great finishing by Rigi right there.
So Montreal is back in it. It's going to be an interesting finish here. 89th minute. Montreal trails by a goal. Still very much alive here, but they're going to need one quickly.
Oh, that's kind of soft.
DI is going to get called for a foul there on Mendoza. Not sure about that one. Obviously, Rochester will take their time as Van de Castiel will play it out wide. Nice anticipation from Charbonneau. Montreal lose possession in the middle of the park. Here's Mendoza with the ball.
Nice run by Dixon.
And Dixon with a nice run.
Ringolf
will try to catch up. Here's Valeski again, but a save by Crépeau to keep them in it.
Beautiful play by the Rhinos. Even better by Crépeau, who keeps his game, his team in the game, like you said.
Secundo will settle things down. Montreal needs a goal here. They're looking for a goal so that it can tie this game. Charbonneau with a long ball to DI. Here's DI.
Gravel going to the
DI PK. Getting it to the box, and it's going to go out off of Apostolopoulos. Montreal earns themselves a corner.
Pressure on the Rhinos. Quick pace by NDI. Looking for Justin Amel and Lajo Gravel going to the box.
Everybody forward now. But it's a short corner. Here's Masudi. Masudi will get it into the box. It's going to be a bit long. Gagnon Lepari able to settle it down. Lajo Gravel. It's cleared away by Rochester. But it's going to go out.
Once again, Dixon. Looking for Valeski making those runs. Nice pass. Nice run by Valeski and an even bigger save by Crépeau. Huge save by Crépeau.
Huge save to keep them in the game.
Great positioning. Reflex uses his feet to make the save. Extension and Valeski could not get his goal in this game again.
The Castile. 3 minutes of added time. And it'll be interesting to see Montreal putting some pressure here. Some heat on Rochester. Here's DI. Alessandro Rigi, who scored the goal to put Montreal back in the game.
Too far for Charbonneau.
That's right, just a little too far.
But you can feel the excitement. You can feel they want to get a second goal. They can do it.
They believe. You feel it. You get the first one, and there you go.
And took advantage of the wings. Faster wingers to really stretch out the Rhinos' defense and make them look bad, and they can still do it.
You know what the sign of a great soccer analyst is, Sofiane?
You will tell
you
me right now.
You say things before they happen. You talked about maybe getting DI into the game a little earlier. They did. And they're able to generate some chances.
Nice by DI. Very good.
DI. Here's Secunda. Secunda will cut back in. Time and space kind of ran out. But here's DI. Blocked.
Frustrating.
By McMahon.
No handball there. But
here's Dixon.
Oh,
Secunda. Tugs on the jersey there as Dixon goes down.
Probably had to stop the counterattack, but great cheeky pass, great cheeky play between Ndiaye and Secunda. Unfortunately, no shot into the shot towards Brandon Miller, but maybe a couple of minutes left, maybe less in the game. The Rhinos killing time.
Here's Temkia. Looked like he was fouled, but he's able to keep the ball in Montreal's favor. Bad ball from Gagnon Lepari there.
Tired bodies on the pitch, and you just hope FC Montreal can have this one cross, one Temkia. Pass into the box, and really a very tired Rhinos team.
Knocks it off.
Trying to survive.
Good call, Sofiane.
Trying to waste time on the touch.
Time winding down here. Here's Rolf. It's going to be a handball there on Charbonneau.
Time winding down for FC Montreal. Scored their first goal in USL.
It's too bad the goal didn't come a little earlier. They have some life here since they've put it in. Here's Ugarte on Charbonneau, but it will go out for a Montreal throw. Gagnon Lepari to Bringolf. He'll try to play. Van de Castiel gets there first. Gagnon Lepari heading it forward to Masudi.
Finds Rigi.
Fortunately turned over by Montreal.
Smart by Dixon, killing time, going across the pitch.
Dixon been so effective since coming on. And that will do it. Unfortunately, Montreal doesn't come up with the result. If you want to look at the positives, Sofiane, they do end up getting a late goal from Alessandro Rigi, their first on home soil as a USL Pro club.
Exactly. We know it was a nice play. Once again, Jackson Amel implicated in the play. And, you know, dribbling, 1-2 with Lajoie Gravel, very important important skills shown on that goal. You know, it wasn't 3-0 as the Rhinos like last time. It was a good competitive game. They were in it all the way. And kudos to the staff to prepare these young kids to be able to almost maybe get the first point in USL.
So, unfortunate result for Montreal again. But again, we game to game, you see steady progress. Steady progress today resulted in a goal. Unfortunately, no 3 points for Montreal. But there's definitely progress there.
There's always going to be regrets when you lose a game. But with the goal, with the positive we see in this, they can build on that and go forward as they go into the season.
You go back to the non-penalty call on Morelli, that maybe changes everything.
It could have changed everything. But Crippo, great showing. 90 minutes as in the first game. And great job on that save to really keep his team alive. And kudos to FC Montreal for an excellent game, looking at the circumstances against a very experienced, strong Rochester Rhinos team.
Montreal will get a little bit of time off here. No game next Saturday. The next game at home, Thursday, May 14th, against the Charleston Battery here at the Saputo Stadium Turf Field. But today, another unfortunate result for Montreal. They lose to Rochester by a score of 2-1. Two goals from Christian Valeski, one goal from Alessandro Rigi. And that's all she wrote. Thank you all for watching on the USL live feed. We hope you enjoyed our coverage of Montreal Rochester. I'm Joey Alfieri. For Sofiane Benzaza, we are out. Thank you.